I think it might not be obvious to people right away why you would need to or want to study processes that go on in the ocean. It might seem kind of esoteric or far away or other, but really what people need to remember is that humans are part of the Earth ecosystem. We're inextricably linked.
When you think of climate change, you often think of what we experience on land. We know the gases, greenhouse gases, carbon dioxide in particular, going up in the atmosphere. But what you might not be thinking about is, well, where else does that carbon go? And a lot of it ends up in the ocean.
And so what's key about this is that oceanographers and earth scientists are really critical to help us understand how man's influence on the earth system is going to influence the oceans and ecosystems there, but also how we might adapt or respond to those changes.
The Woods Hole Oceanographic Institution was founded in 1930, and there's a fairly long history of involvement back and forth between people at MIT and Woods Hole. But the joint program was founded in 1968. There was a two-page memorandum of understanding that was signed by the presidents of both institutions at the time. In the initial days, from the MIT perspective, access to Woods Hole ships at sea was a big feature. For MIT, who had no ships, no access to the ocean, but we had oceanographers and engineers that wanted to study the sea, so we started going down to Woods Hole.
When the joint program was founded, this was a really unique and exceptional partnership that was formed. MIT was this great intellectual innovation powerhouse, and Woods Hole was this remarkable seagoing institution where you could have access to the sea and really go to places where people hadn't gone before. Bringing the two together helped foster an environment where we could train the next generation of earth scientists and oceanographers to really approach problems systematically with deep educational context, but also with access to the experimentation that they needed that was available at the Woods Hole Oceanographic.
So collaborations within and across the institutions are really important in fertilizing new kinds of science and new kinds of breakthroughs, and they enable the students to do new kinds of work.
The reason I joined the program was because we cannot afford to wait to be able to address the climate crisis. To have these large institutions tell you, hey, you know, I see what you want to do, and this is how we can support you.
Yeah.
As opposed to them saying, like, no, you have to stick to this one thing and this one path, and that's what you're stuck on. So the freedom to be able to execute on and have your interests, you know, come to life has been incredibly rewarding.
So for me, fieldwork is one of the best parts of my job. It is one of the coolest experiences you can have. And for me, fieldwork looks like going out to sea on research vessels for several weeks at a time. It's hard work, for sure. It can be an overwhelming experience, but for me personally, it's overwhelming in the best sort of way. To be able to be so hands-on with this zone that no one is really getting to visit, and to be kind of on the frontier of that science is such a unique opportunity. I get to have this once-in-a-lifetime experience that no one else I know who's in my position is getting.
So many people in the field, no matter where they are now, went through HUI in some way, whether that was sailing on HUI ships or being students here, scientists here, postdocs here, and who are some of the best people in the field.
At Woods Hole, there's about 1,000 people, scientists and technicians and engineers and researchers, all working on every aspect of oceanography. That makes it one of the most concentrated and biggest oceanographic institutions in the world.
And in terms of day-to-day research here, if you have a research problem, you can just think of like the top of 5 people in that particular niche of a topic, and they're like either down the hallway or have some association with HUI. It's a really incredible place in terms of connections and just having access to really anything you need.
So as a species and a society, we really want to understand the planet that we live on and our place in it. What we need are people who understand the Earth system, who understand how the climate system works, understand how to interact with that system in order to take care of it and be part of it. And the joint program uniquely produces people with the background, the knowledge, the experience, and the skill sets to be an integral part of addressing those questions into the future.